And now we will continue our studies of flipping properties by learning about how to record renovations or upgrades. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. How do you record property renovation, also called upgrades, at the moment that you pay for them? Well, all the money you pay for upgrades, regardless of the specifics, should be recorded into one fixed asset type of account. You should not use the subaccounts to track the separate type of expense upgrades. The total amount in this account reflects the total value that you have added to the home. This may not directly be related to the amount of market value or selling value, but you're still adding value for the amount that you pay. Let's add a fixed asset account. Let's call it Livingston Street Upgrades or Renovations. We will use this account for any type of upgrade that we pay for, and we'll put it in the chart of accounts as a fixed asset. So of course we remember we click Accounting, and then of course Chart of Accounts. Then we click New, and again this is a fixed asset, and for detail type they actually have leasehold improvements as one of the detail types. And choosing that might help you remember that this account represents all the money that we added, all the additional money that we put into 110 Livingston Street through renovations. So, with cap lock on, 110 Livingston dash renovations. And now this one is on the list and it will represent all the money that we put into renovating the house before selling them. Now let's take a look at our example. Let's imagine on June 10 we paid the vendor Handyman Nedgree to add a room to the house, $5,000. Well, you should be able to do that without my help. You know that you can add a vendor at the moment that you can, at the moment that you're writing a check. So you can click here and you can click check, and I believe the date was June 10, so we're going to put June 10. Now the vendor is not on the list, so we can click add new and type in his name. I think that's from Mr. Rogers, for those people who remember. And of course the account will not be any specific expense, it will be the renovation account that we just made. So 110 Livingston renovations, and that goes up by $5,000 because that's what we paid him to add a room. And when we click save and close, we can open up the report trial balance, and we can see 110 Livingston renovations shows up for the first time as $5,000. What else? June 22nd, paid Con Edison for a special private rewiring job of the house's electrical system. Well, that's not electrical expense, that's more upgrade. And we know that Con Edison is already on the list. Plus sign, check. The date said June 22nd. The vendor whom we paid was Con Edison. Just click yes. Now it's not electrical cost this time. You have to be careful. This time it's property renovations. And the amount, I believe, in the instructions were $4,000. And when we click save and close, we can notice that the renovations account increased and the bank account decreased. Now, the last one, June 28th, we paid Rex Repair Shop to redo the roof, $6,000. Again, any renovation is just a check that you write to your vendor on a specific date. And of course, it's not repair expense this time. It's going into the fixed asset, 110 Livingston Street renovations. And I believe the amount and the instructions say $6,000. Okay, click save and close. Now you can see the total amount of money that we added to the property by way of renovations is accumulated right here, $15,000.